After 20 years of economic sanctions imposed on Sudan, the United States lifts a trade embargo and freezes government assets and removes financial restrictions. This follows an assessment of progress made in Sudan's effort in counterterrorism cooperation and internal conflict. The sanctions relief is already having a positive impact on the economy. Take a look.
Sudan has gradually been coming in from the cold after 20 years of trade and financial sanctions restricting import of U.S. goods and access to frozen government assets. Following diplomatic efforts and assessment of Sudan's improvement in counter-terrorism cooperation, human rights, and handling of internal conflict, President Donald Trump has formally lifted some of the sanctions. The sanctions nearly crippled many of Sudan's vibrant companies and agriculture, a critical sector of the economy. The formal removal brings a glimmer of hope for recovery as the country's currency strengthens.
We hope that the lifting of sanctions reflects on institutions which were top in our history, such as Sudan Airways and Sudan Railways. We also hope that it reflects on the ordinary citizen in terms of services, housing, education, health, environment, and main infrastructure.
Some human rights advocates oppose lifting the sanctions, citing continued rights violations. Though the sanctions relief marks a major turnaround for President Omar al-Bashir, who is wanted by the International Criminal Court on charges of orchestrating a genocide in Darfur, Sudan will remain on the U.S. State Department list of state sponsors of terrorism, alongside Iran and Syria, a decision Sudanese authorities find contradictory.
It is ironic that we are among the best countries in combating terrorism, while still included on the list of countries harboring terrorism. I have been saying repeatedly, this is a paradox. We are still included on the list while we are regarded the best in combating terrorism.
The United States first imposed economic sanctions on Sudan in 1997 when Khartoum, the Sudanese capital, harbored terrorists including Osama bin Laden. These were extended in 2007 in response to the Darfur genocide.
The starting point should be reforming the political situation first, and that will influence the economic situation. When we talk about the political situation, we mean the issue of conflict and peace, because it is the reason so much of the country's wealth and resources have been wasted. If the war continues, it will eat up all the resources, and war has a high price.
Reasons for the softening of America's stance are not quite obvious, but many analysts attribute it to cementing Khartoum's role as a U.S. ally in the fight against terror, a report of Sudan's cutting of ties with North Korea. But travel bans and international asset freezes will remain against those suspected of involvement in the genocide.